At the end of a dirt road in the mountains of El Salvador is a family facing a gut-wrenching decision. Rogelio Galmadez has lived in the United States for the last 17 years. He may soon return here. The Trump administration announced in January they are ending the program that allowed over 200,000 Salvadorans like Rogelio to live legally in the U.S. In 18 months, he could be deported. Rogelio worries about the impact the change in policy could have on the already impoverished and crime-ridden country. The worry is that if there were a massive deportation, he says, this would become, I guess, I would call it a hell. It's a disaster. Everyone wants to work, but there isn't any. So Rogelio has come back to El Salvador for a few weeks with the money he earns working as a landscaper in New York to finish the home he is building here, should he return for good.
So he's telling me that because many other people are thinking that along the same lines as him, that they might need to come back, that it's really hard to get workers right now because so many other people are fixing their homes.
But Rogelio's biggest concern is his three children, all born in the United States. His eldest have been to El Salvador just twice. This is six-year-old Jocelyn's first visit.
What do they know about El Salvador? ¿Qué saben ellos de El Salvador?
Totalmente nada. Totalmente nada.
Rogelio says he doesn't want to live in the U.S. illegally or run the risk of having his family separated. So he may soon move his children, all U.S. citizens, back to El Salvador, one of the most dangerous countries in the world. Even here in the remote countryside, criminal gangs terrorize the population. Barbed wire fencing surrounds Rogelio's house.
For us, it's going to be really hard. And I keep telling him, I like it here, but I wouldn't live here.
They may have no choice. Rogelio would hope to provide his children a better life in the U.S., but is afraid of what could happen if he's deported. The day I'm not with them and they're not with me, he says, I think they're going to suffer, and I will too. Rogelio drives his children to the airport to fly back to the U.S. He will remain in El Salvador a little while longer to finish their home, just in case. They don't know what the future holds, but they say they will do whatever it takes to stay together. Patrick Oppmann, CNN, San Salvador.